Welcome back to Let's Play Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch, the Legend of Heroes series for the PlayStation Portable handheld system. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, and we're on Elza Beach, heading to Ambisch to try to get there before Galga does and destroys the place. What's his name? I always forget his name. Lodi, who's with us. He has some kind of trick up his sleeve for fighting Galga. He's been wanting to fight him. Oh, Mind Potion. Sweet! I've been wanting to fight Galga the entire time since before he even joined our party. Found a Mind Potion. Maybe we'll just use it right away. Use it on Yurio. Thank you for that Mind Potion, very much. Actually, we're not even gonna need it, are we? I assume we can rest here. But we might not have a chance to. Chris says, look, Ambisch soldiers. I guess we made it in time. Look, Bolt's over there. Ah, you're just travelers, the soldier says. What are you thinking, coming to Bolt in times like these? I can't believe you got past the fortress gatekeepers. Yeah, well, that's a tale in itself. See last episode. We're in a rush, Lodi says. Let us pass. I can't do that. I've been told not to let anyone pass because Galga may land and come to Bolt. I'm sorry. I'll have to ask you to go back to the fortress. Oh, no, 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 no. Not after all we went through. Are you kidding? Lodi says. You want us to go back the way we came? Yes, that's right. Lodi, Yurio says. Huh? Here, why don't you show them this? What? Oh, that. What are we showing them? I wonder if it'll work. Oh, Yurio gave Lodi the ring left by Alf, right? Alf is a king of some city or something. Country. Lodi showed the gatekeeper the ring. Yeah, he's really King Alfred. Here, look at this really closely, Lodi says. Open your eyes up and check it out. Since when are you my boss? It's just a ring. Huh? The guard's expression changed. This is the Amdera family crest, the royal rulers of Ambisch. I guess it worked, Chris said. I knew it would, says Yurio. Haha, now you understand, Lodi says. I get it. You're a group of thieves disguised as travelers. Really? From who and where did you steal this ring? What? They all say it in unison. Hey, come over here. We've got some thieves over here. Okay, we're gonna have to fight you guys. What happened? Thieves? Where? Get them! Why does this happen to us? Lodi says. Okay, so bring us to Ambisch or Bolt or whatever and put us in the jail and we'll find our way out from there. At least we'll be inside the city. Jeez, says Chris. Haha. I'm sorry, Yurio says. What should we do with them? Man, we've got other things to do. It's all a misunderstanding, says Yurio. Be quiet. Let's take them to headquarters. Yay, we're getting inside the city. It's one way. Oh, it's Morrison. He got old. We are ready to defend against Galga. Pray to heaven for good fortune. Oh, there's Alfred. A.K.A. Alf. A.K.A. King Alfred. Of Bolt or Ambisch? Or both, I'm not even sure. Torches from Nelva made it in time, too. We did all we could do. I just hope we can stop Galga from getting any farther. Hey, Alf, Yurio says. The soldier says, show some respect. Alfred says, I should have known they were coming. Chris says, it's not fair for you to ditch us like that back there. Yeah, says Yurio. Lodi says, I don't care how important you are in Ambisch. What's wrong is wrong. Morrison says, King Alfred, these people, did they travel with your majesty to Taiyuya? King Alfred, Lodi says. Your majesty? Are you king? I didn't mean any disrespect. Chris says, we don't have to apologize. He's the one who's wrong. Why do we have to get arrested? The soldier says, these people had a ring with an engraving of the royal crest. Yeah, he left it behind. The soldier gave Alf the ring. Alfred says, I gave this ring to them as a token of appreciation. The soldier says, I thought it was odd that these people have a royal ring in their possession. Chris says, why do you think it was us that saved him when he was so hungry he couldn't move? The king is safely here because we were there to help him. Is this how you treat the savior of your king? Yeah, Uriel says. Do they speak the truth? The soldier says. Yes, they do. Like, Alfred's not really helping out here very much. Just tell them they're cool, you know? What the hell? You can go back to where you are now. Yes, your majesty. Finally. I'm sorry I caused you trouble. I gave you the ring as a gift, but I was hoping I could see you again. I didn't want to part with you like that. Lodi says, I thought that you were maybe some bigwig because the King of Nelva knew you, but I never thought you were King of Ambisch. Alfred says, no, I'm really sorry. I was bothered by the prophecy that Gweld had left. The Gweld. I was investigating secretly on Nelva. If I was able to get confirmation of the appearance of Galga sooner, I would have warned King Nordic of Nelva to prepare him for the attack. But Galga got to Nelva the same time I did, and I got separated from Morrison. I met you when I got to Tatuda by mistake. Hirio says, we didn't know any of that. In any case, I gave this ring to you. This is proof of my friendship to you. Please accept this. Hirio and Chris accepted the ring from Alf. Hirio says, thank you, your majesty. I'll take good care of it. Thank you, king, Chris says. Stop calling me those names. It's too strange being called your majesty and stuff by you guys. Just call me Alf, as usual. What a down-to-earth king we have. We can't do that, Lodi says. Well, evidently Chris can, because she says, so Alf, what's Galga's current position? Any change in circumstance? Don't! He says, this morning's report stated that he was at Rotfi Island. He'll awaken anytime soon. He'll probably cross the sea when he does. Yo-Yo asks, are you ready to defend against Galga? We did all we could. Now, I appreciate you coming and all, but leave the rest of the Ambisch army. You guys continue with your pilgrimage. Understood? I agree to the king, Lodi says. Galga is quite an enemy. It's too dangerous to ask Yurio and Chris to fight with us. You guys will just get in the way. Hey, we're pretty mighty warriors now. Chris says, aw. Leave Galga to me, Lodi says. I promise I'll defeat him. Lodi? Alfred says. I don't want to put you in danger either, but now that you're here, I have no right to stop you. Well, I don't want to get back to, like, a two-member team again. What do you want to do, Chris? Yurio says. I understand what Alf and Lodi are saying, but there must be something we can do. I think so, too. I don't want to just pass a bolt and go on to Agunis. Hey, Alf, let's do this, then, Chris says. Huh? What are we going to do? We won't participate in the battle. When Galga comes, we'll hide in a safe place. It's okay, isn't it? Until then, we'll help out with whatever we can, okay? No, that's not okay. It's still too dangerous. I see, Chris says. You can't listen to the request of the savior of your life, is that it? But... Chris says. Okay. I can't win a staring contest with you. Listen, the deal is that you and Yurio don't fight in the battle. You can keep a promise, can't you? Yurio and Chris say, of course. Morrison says, is that okay? They're here, Alfred says. What can I do? My tent is the one farthest east. I'll have it prepared for your stay. Come back later. Okay. Morrison? You can walk around the town freely. Just don't get in the way of the soldiers. I need to talk to Morrison about the battle against Galga. I'll see you at the tent later. Okay. We will explore. What'd you find? Make your... No, thanks. We will buy some stuff. Vice, the arms dealer, says, welcome. What can I do for you? You can sell us stuff. Okay, steel sword. Yo-Yo and what's his name have? Lodi. Summon dagger. We could go down and attack with that. Yeah, never mind. A rune dagger used in magic rituals. I don't know if it has any spells on it. It doesn't say. Silver staff for Chris. She has that already. Small shield. I guess they have that already. You gonna sell us something new? Split mail? Moonlight robes. Defense goes down. Oh, Lodi can wear it too. Magic defense goes up, but if defense goes down. Otherwise it'd be 53. Or 61. Yeah, I'm gonna pass up that. Come again. Sweet. I do like the water. Are you the well maiden? Shella says, we run an inn here. We're usually filled with people coming to the beach, but this year it's banned because of Galga. I just wish this gets over with soon. Man, what if Galga doesn't come like they say he will? We've lost all of our customers. Hello, sir. Elder Gimli says, we just remodeled our old inn. Aw, man. All I hear are crickets. This is the time of the year we make our money. Alright. I can't walk around him, otherwise I'd... Okay. Hi. Pesuka the fisherman says, is Galga really coming? He's still sleeping at Rotfi Island, right? I also heard about the witch's prophecy, but he could swim off to somewhere else. Chris says, I wish the prophecy is wrong, but so far, the Gweld... Why are we calling the Gweld? Gweld's prophecy has never been wrong. I knew it. Man, we haven't had any business. I sure wish this Galga thing gets over quickly. That chair looks very interesting. Oh. Piala says, I heard that Galaga's coming to attack us. I wonder if it's true. If it is, that's pretty scary. I heard that Negar Island and Nelva were destroyed by Galga. I wonder if Bolt's going to be okay. So worried. So worried. Morato, the chapel master, says, welcome to the chapel in Bolt. Okay, we sell food. Please visit us whenever you need food for your pets or something like that. Now, if we go... Yeah, if we go behind the counter, they say something else. I'll have to go talk to the weapons guy. We have to do our best at times like these. No thanks. Cannot take it. Let's go behind the counter and talk to him. Weapons are selling like crazy now that Galga is coming. I don't want to make the fisherman mad, but I hope this trend keeps up. Go ahead and look at all the stuff you want. Thank you. Was this the... yeah. We talk to him. Oh, I'm like, where the hell are we? Huh? So there's nothing else down around here. No. It's like scrolls and stuff. Illegal says, welcome, what can I do for you? Okay. She sells this stuff, we don't need that. Welcome. Our shop's been busy because soldiers come to our store now, too. I'm worried about Galga, but it's good to have good business. Be sure and buy everything you need, okay? Which is about zero, because we have those potions. There's the tent. Let's go there last. Laura, the fisherman, says, I can't believe that the king believed the prophecy enough to bring all these soldiers. Oh, what do you say? Ah! I don't believe in the prophecy. When I go fishing, I go fishing. When I rest, I rest. The reason I'm not fishing right now is because it's time to rest. I'm not staying home because I'm afraid of Galga. Yeah, sure, sure. You spin a good tail. Oh. And we... zone a good zone. Mrs. Halise says, the king forbade us from going fishing. My husband is so depressed that he can't go fishing. Is he the one who says he's not hiding from Galga? I understand how he feels, but it's so childish for him to cry at home because he can't fish. Yeah. Molsa, the fisherman, says, I never skipped a single day of fishing. I went no matter how rainy or windy it was. Yeah, he's probably her husband. But it's the king's orders. I want to go out. The sea is great. Many fish jump out of the waters. I want to go out to sea. I want to go fishing. I kind of annoyed myself talking that way. Oh, what do we have here? Guard post? Oh. Hello. We're making sure that no one goes out to fish. We don't know when Galga will be here. It's too dangerous to go out to sea. I know that the fishermen understand, but we just want to make sure. Alright. Let's go check out that guard post. Oh. Actually, go up. Thank you. Chris says, you still can't see Galga? Nope, there's nothing to see. Still, like, as if we've talked to him before. So I know the tent's down there. Anything else up here? Well, we can go all this way. We can zone in. Oh. Wait a second. Yo-Yo asks, you still can't see Galga? No, no movement yet. I just see Rafi Island far away. Kids, don't go over there. It's dangerous. Oh, brother. Alright, well, that's it for this zone. For now, anyway. I guess we're going to the tent. Oh, we have a few different tents. Oh. Nope, don't need that. Hi! The lady in the back is awesome. She's the Canned Master. The title of Canned Master is only given to the ones that master the art of spells. It's not common to see a Canned Master. Ms. Magisa is a Canned Master of Canned Spells. Got it. King Alfred has summoned the Canned Master to stop Galga here. It's scary to fight against Galga, but if the Can Master is fighting with us, it's a little better. Just a little. We were attacked by Galga off guard at Nelva, but it'll be different in Ambisch. We will plan things carefully and get ready for the battle. We can't let Ambisch, our homeland, be destroyed by a single sea monster. Oh, she has an exclamation mark. We'll come back to her. I want to talk to all these other optional people first. Oh, I like the sound of the fire there. Awesome. You're the king's friends, right? The king isn't back yet. Did you see the Can Master at the temporary barracks? She's great. She's a Can Master at her age, and on top of that, she's beautiful. I really admire her. No, we're gonna go talk to her soon. Oh, you're the king's friends, right? Are you leaving Bolt? No, we're not leaving yet, Yo-Yo says. We're just taking a walk. We're sorry to interrupt you, says Chris. Oh, okay. No, don't worry about it. We are guarding this area so travelers don't wander into Bolt without knowing. Keep up your good work, Chris says. Alright, so there's that tent, there's the other, and there's a third tent, there's one here. Etoff, the Can Master, says, the Can have no shops in Bolt, so we came here from Castle Amdara. Oh, we can buy, food. Why are you a Can Master, but you sell pet food? Don't need the pet food. There's so much of it. Sorry we gave you trouble earlier, but anyone would think it's weird for you to have the king's ring. You shouldn't show it off to people that often. Yeah, I can see that bard and what's his name trying to steal it from us. Looks like all is clear for now. I just hope nothing happens. Okay, so that's that one with the one guard in it. I think I have been in here, yeah. Did I talk to her? I think so. Yeah. What's up here? Oh, nothing. Alright, so I think we've talked to everybody. Let's go talk to this Can Master. Hello, nice to meet you, Chris says. Magisa says, hi, nice to meet you. She is pretty. I'm Chris. This is Yurio and Lodi. We're all traveling together. Hello, Yurio says. Oh, hello there, Lodi says. Magisa says, the king told me that you guys are on a pilgrimage. He also told me that Chris can use chapel spells. May I? Magisa put her hand on Chris's forehead. Huh? Chris says. He's right. You have great potential. Hope you can maximize your skills to help everyone out. I met Gweld when I was 5 years old. Huh? Gweld? Yurio says. Yes, she was known as the Moonlight Witch. Okay, so you're a lot older than you look then. I learned a lot from Gweld. She taught me how to use spells properly, how to interact with people, and how to interpret prophecies. Lodi says, wow. You were trained directly by Gweld. I don't know. Gweld taught me more how to handle spells rather than spells themselves. I guess my master for spells was King Alfred's butler, Mr. Morrison. Huh. Funny. The butler. Usually the butler is named Alfred. Oh, I see, Lodi says. Under proper training, Chris, you can become a great chapel master. Okay. Next? These people say anything new. Alright, now we're going to the tent? Is it this tent? Yes, we did. We did see her. Rumbling from hunger. Let's give you organic food this time. I know, all we do is feed you stuff you don't like. Maybe that's why you're so pissed all the time. Is that the tent he was... Yeah, I guess that's the tent he was supposed to be in. But he's not there. Let's run over here again, I guess. See if he's seen Galga. And he's not gonna let us go this way. Yeah, dangerous. We laugh in the face of danger. Alright, so who do we have to talk to now to get things going? Still standing over here? No, they're gone. No thanks. We just remodeled our old inn. Out of my way, old man. Ugh. Did you say this before? I heard the Galga's coming to attack us. I wonder if it's true. If it is, that's pretty scary. Yeah, I read that part. Not need food for the pet. Who do we need to go visit? It's so funny though, he's a can master, but he's selling pet food. Did we talk to him? Yeah, we did before. I never skipped a single day of fishing. I went no matter how rainy or windy it was, but it's the king's orders. Oh yeah. He's the whiner. Talk to her again. Oh. Well, she was somebody very important to talk to, and she didn't have that much to say. Oh, they're there now. Sweet. I guess you can just leave and come back. I can't say this too loudly, but the king's pretty nervous too, I hear. Alright. Talk to Morrison. Sorry I couldn't properly say farewell at Taiyuyao. The king didn't want to leave, but the situation required immediate departure. Please forgive me. It's okay, Chris says. I understand what happened. You should have just let us on your boat, Yurio says. Oh, it's his boat? We are now prepared for the battle against Galga. Now all we can do is pray for our victory. Let's talk to Alf. Oh, sorry to keep you waiting. Thanks for coming all the way here. I didn't think you'd make it in time. Well, we were waiting for you. Unless you meant just the journey in general. I can't believe you just left us behind, Chris says. Sorry. But thanks to that, the materials from Menarth made it in time, and we were able to prepare to defend before it gets here. Yurio says, but I'm really surprised that Alf was the king of Ambisch. Ahem. That's why you can't judge people just by their appearance. Anyway, let's talk about what happened after we finish our battle against Galga. Listen, I'm telling you again, even after Galga arrives, I don't want you guys to get involved in the battle. Even if you guys are strong, it's the sea monster Galga that we're up against. Leave the battle up to the pros. Alright. Are we gonna go look out for him at the lookouts? Chris says, oh, I remember Grandma Jean saying something at Tuyuyal. Something about Gwelting saying to make a path of light to guide the way. Yurio says, that's why you got so much special fishing fire to guide Galga. Lodi says, Ambisch wouldn't have enough to fill up the entire shoreline. Yurio says, but I wonder if that's enough to guide Galga. We'll see. I think we have a shot at it. Chris says, I wonder where they plan on leading Galga. I don't know. I guess we can tell if we just follow the fishing fire. Right. Well, we got these fires. But we want some fire right up against the sea, right? Let's go check in with this guard. So we're gonna try to put up more fires for them? Or what? We're okay, Chris says. Don't worry about us. The king gave us permission. Huh? Yurio says. Did we say anything like that? I wonder if there's monsters over here. Oh look, stairs up. Alright, we're gonna go up the stairs or further east. That's further east. I hear the fires though. Why do we stop? Why do we stop like that? Oh. Ah, okay. Can't open that? It looked like a chest to open. Here, the Galga is about 80 milos in size. He's just big enough to fill this valley. He shivers. That was just a battle shake. A battle shake? Alright, let's check out. Well, we need to get down. Alright. Not sure if we have to, but. Can we walk along the ledge here? Oh, just there. We We made the footholds to climb the rocks, and everything is ready. We're ready for Galga any time now. Oops, get past you. So, follow the fires, they say. Oops. What do you think? We're going to connect the fishing fire path from the sea to the torches here. According to our research, Galga will follow the path of the fire. We're ready. We can guide him to the dead end in the valley. Hmm. Nope. Do not need. See if there's anyone else to talk to. I don't know where the dead end of the valley is. Is it this way or to the east? Oh, he's important. Let's hit him last, I guess. Oh, yet we can go further this way. Let's even go further east as well. It can't be too much further. Oh, it ends here. Got it. All right. The music is excellent, as always. Got a mind potion, sweet. I think we have 9 now. Yes. Let's throw a save in. Let me just take a quick peek down here before we talk to him. Is this the dead end in the valley? I mean, Galga wouldn't run all the way in here, would he? Oh, it is a dead end. Maybe this is where they want to see if they can beach Galga, I guess, and then attack. Seems like a pretty good plan. Howdy. I'm preparing the large net to stop Galga's movements. It's a large net made of special material. It's so strong it can catch a whale. A whale? Mirio says. Really? I've never heard catching a whale with a net. Chris says, I'm just saying that's strong enough for a whale. Okay, Chris is saying that. Okay. That's what I meant. You. We don't know when Galga will be coming. Don't wander around too much. You should stay within the city. All the other operations are complete. You won't find anybody up ahead. Okay. So now that we talk to him, something should happen. Run back to the dead end again. No thanks. Wouldn't mind another mind potion or remind potion. I don't think we'll find anything down here, but just because we talked to him with the exclamation point, he's important. Another mind potion, sweet. We're topped off on those now. For those who don't know or remember, you can only carry 10 of each item. And now we have 10 mind potions. There's still nothing here. Let's head back to, I guess, I don't know. Back towards the town? We could explore up top. Up here. See if there's anything up here. Oh. Yeah, it's pretty much a dead end. Although I think, yeah, we can go this way. We haven't looked around up here, I don't think. And we can't go any further. Okay. Probably be a safe place to hang out or to attack Galga with missile weapons. Although Galga's so huge, probably be eye to eye with it standing up there. Alright, so now what? We head back? I mean, we're supposed to follow these fires to see where. And we wanted to help in some way. And we've done so, so I guess we head back. Oh, look! They've got all these, like, buoys. What's in the middle of them? You guys have been busy while we've been wandering around at the end. Huh. Unless I didn't move enough north and didn't see that. You're, like, pissed again. Okay, you're hungry. And more angel food. Oh, look! They've gone from the tent. Are they gathering for the big arrival? Oh! They're giving a speech.